I can be very funny about Tolstoy. I read the whole damn thing last night.
Really?
No, I didn't. But I did at one point.
That'd be a record if you'd read it in one night. That'd be amazing.
No, I read it. I think it went from I was in the 7th grade to the 8th grade. I just, you know,
wow.
I was this little kid carrying around this big book.
What
and everybody
that?
Thought I was so pretentious in Catholic school. But anyway, I couldn't put it down. I was like, I wanted to know how it came out. I think the French won. I'm not sure.
A real page turner.
A page turner. War and Peace. We're talking about War and Peace with James McAvoy. Oh,
hello.
My God, James McAvoy. How are you doing, man? You're an international movie star now.
Thank you very much. I'm doing all right, really. I'm really happy to be here talking about this film, and it's nice to be a part of that. Nice to be in New York in the winter, so it's cool, yeah.
Yeah. The last time I saw you was for Atonement.
Yep.
That beautiful old house. And your very talented wife, I think, is in this, isn't
yeah,
she?
Yeah,
she Anne-Marie Duff. I'm just taking a wild guess here.
Yeah.
That's your wife.
Yeah.
She's this very, very talented.
No, she's cracking. She just won the British Independent Film Award for Best Supporting Actress for a film called Nowhere Boy.
Oh,
so she's doing.
Wow.
Yeah, she's cracking.
Wow. And I thought, is that her? And then it was like, but you didn't have scenes together. She's
not really. We wouldn't really take a film where we had to do a lot of acting with each other because it's just, you know, your relationship on film and in life and all that kind of stuff would have been just.
Well, I'd do it if we had to do that together. I would do it, James.
If we get married, we'll work together.
All right, okay.
We'll still interview each other when we get married.
No, you're interviewing me. Well, that's okay. You said you couldn't make Tolstoy funny, but I can. Anyway.
I don't know. I do think actually this film is quite funny.
Helen Mirren.
Oh, she's
hilarious. Is that over the top? That performance. It's so over the. She was like eating the entire Russian landscape.
Totally. She was chewing it up and spitting it out. She's fantastic in it.
Yes.
And that's what really made me like the script was the fact that not just was it a good story, not just because it was Tolstoy and all that. It had a real sort of Chekhovian sense of humor. And I felt that was slightly different from most period biopic costume dramas that I've seen. You know?
Well, you know, the Russians are very funny people. And that woman, the wife of Leo Tolstoy, and they're fighting over his estate and everything, she was just, I mean, those outfits, I mean, that's camp, I'm sorry.
She was camp. She's definitely camp in it.
And I've never seen Helen, go over
really
the moon cool. like that.
No, I know. I think that's what attracted her to it as well. The chance to kind of go crazy. The chance to really, really sort of pitch something that high. And what's great about the film is
in every single scene.
Yeah, no, totally.
She's losing her marbles.
When people feel something in this movie, it fills the entire room. And she's at the highest end of that spectrum.
Yes.
So when she feels something, it blows the roof off the house, you know. But yeah, I think that's probably what drew her to it.
And she plays Leo Tolstoy's devoted wife in The Last Station, and she evidently copied War and Peace six times by hand. No wonder she was like so crazy.
Yeah, no, she kind of felt like she owned the work a little bit. I think she felt creatively responsible for some of the work as well, not just that she copied it out. She would, you know, she kind of story edited for him. And yet,
and she inspired him, obviously.
Oh, completely. She
the
was
Countess Tolstoy, yeah.
Yeah, and while he was off, you know, having affairs with other people as well, she was doing all this. So it was an incredible, incredible woman.
And you're like the innocent young person who sort of stumbles into this crazy household.
He's in love with Tolstoy. He's, you know, Tolstoy's his messiah, you know?
Who's played by Christopher Plummer, another stupendous performer. An underplay.
Great.
I mean, as over the top as Helen is, he's sort of really under the radar,
you know,
with the contrast.
He's incredible in it, I think.
Yes, he is. Oh, he's a great actor.
Josh.
I saw his Lear, which was magnificent.
Where, up at Ontario?
And they brought it to New York, and I saw here, and it was the way Lear should be played, you know?
Yeah.
And he didn't carry, you know, what's-her-face in Cordelia. He dragged her in. That's cheap because of course he's an old man and he couldn't lift her. He wouldn't be able to lift a dead body.
Maybe
like
his
that.
Eyes, I suppose.
You know, that's the big.
Just got to hire a midget to play Cordelia and he'll be fine.
Right.
Can we find somebody who's 4 foot 2?
Right. Didn't your wife also play Queen Elizabeth?
She's actually played Cordelia to Ian Holm.
Oh.
She played Queen Elizabeth first from the age of 17 to the age she died.
And a TV series, right, which came here, so our viewers.
I think it was Masterpiece Theatre or something like that over here.
Yeah,
it was a four-part BBC thing.
She's a stupendous. Congratulations, you're married to a brilliant woman.
I'm a lucky man.
And she's a lucky lady. My God, James McAvoy, all our all our viewers and readers on YouTube and everything are all think she's the lucky one. You're the lucky one. That's
definitely
great.
Definitely.
A happy marriage in Hollywood. How fabulous. How rare.
Well, we don't live in Hollywood, so that's why we get away with it, I think.
Right. Do you live in Scotland?
I live in London.
London. Okay. Yeah. Thank you, James.
Lovely,
right.
to see you, James.
Thank you. The last station. Okay. It's always great.
Thank you.
See
you. You too.